ओम नमः शिवाय 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 पार्वती पतये हर हर महादेव की जय।
तथैया नाचे भोला तथैया नाचे भोला तथैया नाचे भोला तथैया नाचे भोला बम बाबा बजेगा बम बाबा बजेगा तथैया नाचे भोला गरजे गंगा छोटा माझे उगोरे अनल त्रिशूल राजे गरजे गंगा छोटा माझे उगोरे धक 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 मौली बंध 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 जले शशंक भाल तथैया नाचे भोला तथैया नाचे भोला बम बाबा बाजे गाल बम बाबा बाजे गाल दिमी 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 डमरु बाजे दिमी 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 डमरु बाजे धुनी छे कपाल माल तथैया नाचे भोला तथैया नाचे भोला गरजे गंगा छोटा माझे उगोरे अनल त्रिशूल राजे गरजे गंगा छोटा माझे उगोरे अनल त्रिशूल राजे धक 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 मौली बंध धक
हरि बोलो हरि डमरु डम डम
शिव 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 हरि बोलो हरि डमरु डम डम Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Dam Dam Bole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam 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 Bole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam
Dam Dam Bole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Dam Dam Bole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam Shiva Om Shiva Om Shiva Om
Shiva Om Shiva Om Shiva Om
Shiva Om Shiva Om Shiva Om Hari
Om Shiva Om Hari Om
Shankar Bhole Madhav Bhole Bam 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 Bhole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam Bam Bam Bhole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam
Bam Bam Bhole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Shiva Hari Bolo Hari Damaru Dam Dam
Dam Dam Bole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam
Dam Dam Bole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bole Dam Dam
Shiva Om Shiva Om
Shiva Om
Shiva Om Hari Om
Shiva Om Hari Om
Shiva Om Hari Om
Shiva Om Hari Om
Shankar Bhole Madhav Bhole Bam 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 Bhole Mahadev Ki Damaru Bhole Dam Dam
நடல் விட ஏ
तेने गुडल वोच दीपिन याइन तीरा तेची तेने गुडल वोच दीपिन याइन तीरा तेची तेने गुडल वोच दीपिन याइन तीरा तेची तेने गुडल वोच சாட்சிய பாடல்கள் பார்த்தும் வல்லவர் நல்லவர் தாமே சாட்சிய பாடல்கள் பார்த்தும் வல்லவர் நல்லவர் தாமே
दाहिका शक्ति रामकृष्णे स्थिता हिया सर्वविद्यास्वरूपां तां शारदां प्रणमाम्यहं शारदां प्रणमाम्यहं ओम नमः शिवाय रिवियर्ड माताजी डियर सिस्टर्स एंड ब्रदर्स Om Namo Narayanaya. We have been blessed to sing the Lord's holy name on this auspicious night. During these difficult times, when many people are facing challenges, we pray to Lord Shiva to be compassionate to us. The Lord swallowed the poison to save and protect the world. May He remove all our obstacles and allow us to worship Him always. The Master Sri Ramakrishna said, "One should cultivate a spiritual attitude towards God and have faith in Him. Hold on to Him firmly and make Him your own. Think of God as your father, mother, or as your best friend. As is one's meditation, so is one's feeling of love. As is a man's feeling of love, so is his gain, and faith is the root of all. Part of the mind should be directed towards God always. Only then will we succeed. We often wonder if God listens to our prayers. We admire devotees who have deep faith in God. The Lord bestows His grace on them since they are earnest and devoted to Him. In Sri Salem, at the foothills of the Himalayas, is a famous temple of Lord Shiva. There is an interesting story about the celebration of Mahashivaratri here. Near Sri Salem is a village where Ramana, a 9-year-old boy, lived. He learned from his friends that their sisters and brothers-in-law were coming to their homes to attend the Shivaratri celebrations on the Sri Salem hills. Ramana told his mother to invite his sister and brother-in-law to the festival. His mother said that he had no sister and therefore no brother-in-law, but he would not listen. He insisted that he must have a sister and a brother-in-law like his friends. To pacify him, his mother replied, "Oh yes, you have a sister and a brother-in-law, but they are in the temple near Sri Salem. Their names are Brahmaramba and Mallika Arjuna." She gave him the names by which Lord Shiva and Mother Parvati are known, Brahmaramba meaning bee and Mallika Arjuna meaning the white jasmine. Hearing this good news, Ramana was overjoyed. He eagerly hastened up the hill and ran into the temple crying, "Oh, my sister and brother-in-law." He fell at the feet of the images and held them in loving embrace. In his enthusiasm and ecstasy, he began to drag them with him. Clasping the images of Lord Shiva and Mother Parvati, he wanted to take them home. The priest of the temple thought that he was insane and drove him out. Ramana was distraught. He climbed a high rock and threatened to jump unless his sister and her husband came home with him. Just then, he heard an aerial voice from the temple. "Oh Ramana, my brother-in-law, do not be hasty. We are coming home with you." Ramana was blessed to have the vision of Lord Shiva and Mother Parvati. Touched by the sincere and earnest appeal of the young boy, they accompanied him to his cottage in the valley. Ramana and his mother were overwhelmed with divine bliss. His devotion and faith enabled him and his dear mother to actually see God and be merged in Him. This story has added to the sanctity of the shrine of Brahmaramba and Mallika Arjuna at Sri Salem. The scriptures say that one who bathes in the holy Ganga becomes pure, since all the vices are washed away. Sri Ramakrishna said, "The Ganga is the flowing Brahman. One who lives on the banks of the Ganga, his heart becomes like that of the gods. The breeze filled with the sacred particles of the Ganga purifies the land on both sides as far as it blows. However, we must have faith in this." Once Lord Shiva and Mother Parvati were traveling on earth. Goddess Parvati saw thousands of people going to the sacred Ganga to have their bath. They knew that the Ganga will wash away their sins and they will attain liberation. Mother Parvati asked Lord Shiva, is it possible for all of them to attain moksha simply by bathing in the holy river? Lord Shiva smiled and said, no, only those who have devotion, pure thoughts, and do not repeat their wrong actions after their bath will achieve moksha. Most of them see it as a mere ritual. They try to convince themselves that they are pious. Mother Parvati further inquired, many make a great effort to come from long distances. Surely they must be earnest in their spiritual quest. Lord Shiva and Mother Parvati decided to test this. Lord Shiva disguised himself as a leper and Mother Parvati was his loyal wife. They came to the bank of the Ganga where Mother said in a pleading tone, all of you are bathing in the Ganga, so you must be pure. Please help me to take my husband to the river so that by touching the waters, he can be cured of this leprosy. Many looked at her in wonder. Some pretended not to hear her at all. Others showed disgust, and a few tried to convince her to leave her husband. Amazingly, no one offered any assistance. It was already midday, and still no one came to their aid. Finally, one man who heard Mother Parvati's plea thought to himself, I always chant Om Namah Shivaya, so I am pure by the grace of God. Yet, I will quickly take a dip in the Ganga and help the leper perform his holy bath. He chanted Har Har Mahadev and gladly took a dip in the Ganga. He then lovingly helped the sick man to the Ganga and poured the water over the leper. Then he simply greeted them and left, without asking for anything in return. Lord Shiva then said to Mother Parvati, do you see, this man alone has attained moksha because he has implicit faith in the sacred waters of the Ganga. We often perform rituals, chant mantras, and repeat God's holy name. How much of faith do we have that these have purified us? Sri Sharada Devi reassures us, the mantra purifies the body. Man becomes pure by repeating the name of God. So repeat his name always. It is important to have faith to make progress in spiritual life. Recently, Swami Vijayananda, a senior monk of the Ramakrishna order, recalled a remarkable incident. He was the head of the Argentina Center for many years and then returned to India. On his return to India, he was fortunate to meet some of the master's direct disciples. Swami Adbhutananda, lovingly known as Lattu Maharaj, was one of them. Although unlettered, Lattu Maharaj was known as Sri Ramakrishna's miracle and was a knower of Brahman. Swami Vijayananda recalls, while living in Benares, I used to visit Lattu Maharaj. One day he asked me, did you go to the Ganga to have a bath? No, Maharaj, I answered. This is the rainy season and the Ganga is very dirty at this time. Lattu Maharaj then asked, did you visit the temple of Lord Vishwanath? This is another name of Lord Shiva. Swami Vijayananda did not believe in God with form and always meditated on the formless aspect of God or Brahman. He therefore replied, well, Vishwanath to me is just a black stone. Don't say that, cried Lattu Maharaj excitedly. Then glancing at me compassionately, he said, well, you are strong, bold, and simple. May Lord Vishwanath be gracious to you. Some days later, when I was sitting on the bank of the river Ganges, I saw many things floating by, boats, flowers, offerings, and other articles. Everything seemed calm and still. Suddenly, I gazed at the beautiful holy river. I saw something coming up from the middle of the water. The form grew bigger and bigger. I was mesmerized to see that it was Lord Shiva's head with matted hair. Soon the shoulders too were visible. It was the benign form of Lord Vireshwar Shiva emerging from the Ganges. As the form grew large, it covered the Ganges from one end to the other. I was so overwhelmed that I fell unconscious. The attendant took me to the ashram. When I regained consciousness, I quickly went to meet Lattu Maharaj. Maharaj smiled and asked me, "Ah, Pashupati, did you see Lord Mahadev?" I fell at his feet and exclaimed, "The Lord was gracious to me, Maharaj, through your blessings." The divine spark of Lord Shiva is in all of us. It becomes revealed to us through the grace of the Guru. Today, people are facing many difficult challenges like health problems, being jobless, family disagreements, and many more. How do we deepen our faith in God and increase our devotion to Him? Our scriptures say that God cannot be known through the senses. Regular prayer and meditation awaken the divine power within and allow us to feel the presence of God in our hearts. Practical solutions to many challenges are to be found in the interesting lives and teachings of our Master Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother Sri Sharada Devi, and Swami Vivekananda, who make God living for us. They help us to awaken our innate divinity so that we can progress Godward. On this blessed occasion, we pray to Lord Shiva to shower his choicest blessings on all of us. Please take care and be safe. Om Namo Narayanaya.
Yeah. Om Namo Narayanaya, dear sisters and brothers. Through the grace of Lord Shiva, we were able to sing his glories on this auspicious night. O Lord, we pray to you humbly. Please bless us with love and devotion so that we may realize the supreme truth. Please help us to transform our vices into virtues. May we feel your divine presence in our hearts and know that we are not alone. May you be our guiding light through life's difficult journey. O compassionate Lord, please save us from error. Please bless us and always protect us. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Om Jaya Ganga Dhaira Haira Shiva Jaya.
Oh. mangalam bhavatu sarve bhavantu sukhinah sarve santu niramaya sarve bhadrani pashyantu ma kaschid dukha bhag bhave om purnamaya purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vashishyate om shanti 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 hari om tat sat
jai shri guru maharaj ki jai mahamai ki jai स्वामी जी महाराज की जय गंगा मात की जय महावीर स्वामी जी की जय सर्व ऋषि मुनियों की जय
पार्वती पते हर हर महा